Thank you very much, Dr. Bhupesh. Can you hear me? All of
Yes,
you, can
we
you hear
can.
me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Very good. So first, my hearty wishes to Dr. Ranjit and his team for organizing this excellent forum for the benefit of researchers, academicians, and whoever interested in forensic science. And the another problem is here, normally we are doing a lot of research, right? How to identify the trace, the fingerprint evidence, something like that. But the criminals, they are acting in a different way. How to avoid the fingerprint in the crime scene? There is a great challenging to the crime scene investigators. Since I was in the crime scene for more than 2 decades in India, that's why I know the problem of this one, right? So likewise, whatever the challenges we are doing is one, the experts should have find out the evidence in the crime. That is important for us, because many of them, after they committing the crime, what they do is they just destroy the evidence in the form of or something like that, right? So likewise here, when I become an academician, I got some idea about the we know the fingerprints are living there because they have the inheritance property or something like that. Then I plan to do it in what way the fingerprints are used to link the family members, right? So that's a very interesting topic for me, and it's a pilot study in Malaysia, right? So who is even the more affection towards the children? Mother has affection towards son or daughter? Who is? Of course, mother has affection towards both son and daughter. So which is the most, right? Comparatively, which is so likewise. I am doing this research in Malaysia. So they are just presenting my findings here. So this one, all of you know this one already, the fingerprint is a well-known and published biometric. So this is globally accepted to identify both life and death, right? Even sometimes dead bodies. So we could not find out who is this person. So if it is so, the chances to take the fingerprint of the deceased and compare with the documents available in the records or something like that. So likewise, we are doing this one, right? And after that, what they do is, early day, they are using the lens, right? Seeing physically, manually. In the 80s, we are doing the manually to compare the fingerprint. Now, because of the latest technology, we have the automated fingerprint identification, everything is there, right? Next slide. So here, already the speakers also told that. So we have whenever we are seeing any fingerprint, basically we can see some of the patterns here, right? Normally we have some black lines are there. Within the black line, we have some white spaces are there. So likewise, these are some of the points we can see in the fingerprint, right? Next, please. So now, this is some of the crime scene I visited in India, wherein the dead bodies were identified through the fingerprints here. So at the top left, you can see one person was killed by the public itself, because in the night time, some unknown person entered a house and tried to attempt to rape. So immediately, it's a village, it's a small village. So giving an alarm, all the people, they came out of gym and they killed the person. Nobody knows who is this person, right? So immediately they called me, myself and the DSP, he is watching the dead body, who is this person? He was beaten by the public, not or something like that. Then later he did not identify who is this person. Then the only chance is fingerprint. We have collected the fingerprint, we found this record. In the record, it is not there. So record means normally in the police record, who are committing the crime, earlier crime or convict or suspect, their fingerprints are there. If it is a first offender, mean there is no chance of getting their fingerprint of this one. Then after that, we are keeping the fingerprint, we identify after 2 weeks time or something like that, right? And at the bottom photo, there is an old man was found dead in a forest area, right? At the time, he was an unknown person. The body was identified after 2 days. The body, you can see the decomposed condition of this one. Then after that, they have corrected the fingerprint, we are able to identify the person, who is this person. And another one in a train, so the train was stopped at the destination. So when the cleaner come and see this one, there is a dead body inside the toilet, right, with the cut injuries or something like that. Then it has registered the railway police, Indian railway police registered this one. Normally what I do is, the railway police, they have the limited jurisdiction of this one, right? They have no public contact with or something like that. So normally this type of cases, what they do is, they transfer to the local police. Right. Similarly, when the railway police arrested me, they called me to visit the place. So I visited the place. He is a young man. He is a young person of the zone. He is having the cut injuries on the neck region or something like that. Then after that, the only possibility is fingerprint. We have collected the fingerprint. Then after that, we identify after 3 or 4 weeks or something like that, right? So here, the fingerprint is used to identify the dead people there. Next, please. Then after that, the some of the fire cases, in the cases I visited in many cases there, sometimes what they do is, in the fire investigation, the main aim is to identify the origin, source, where the fire started and what is the cause. So we have to answer these two questions in the fire investigation. Where the fire started and what is the cause of the fire, something like that. So if it is so, sometimes what they do is, they intentionally set fire, that is called the arson. The expert, they know this one. So arson case means they intentionally set fire to the other's property or their own property. The own property in this end for the purpose of claiming insurance or something like that. So here, these are all the some of the arson cases wherein they are using the kerosene, using the bottle or container or tin or something like that. They throw away this one. So in that places, you could be able to collect the empty container and the glass bottle, there we could be able to identify the collect the fingerprint, then tally with the accused or something like that. So likewise, the fire incident cases, all the fingerprint play a vital role in the identification of the source, right? Next, please. So this is another incident. One policeman, he found dead in the house, right? He's a policeman. He found dead in the house where, he found that with his rifle. Normally, police people, they have their rifle of this one. The body was found in the position as shown in the photo, right? What he did was, he just fixed the rifle using his toe, he triggered and shot that. But is it true? How far it is true? So there, then we went to the crime scene. It appears like we have to find out whether it's a suicide or murder. Some people, what they do is, they murdered him and they created a suicide crime scene. I visited many of the crime scenes like that, right? So likewise here, what I did was, he handled the rifle, we could able to collect the fingerprint, and also we have collected the impression of the toe and the trigger guard. But very, very little fragments were there. Of course, just to confirm this one, I collected the toe print also. Toe print as well as the fingerprints in the rifle also, though. Then finally confirmed that. So he committed suicide. Then after that, we were sent for the autopsy. In the autopsy also, they further confirmed this one. So wherever the bullet marks are there in the wall and other region, and finally I reconstructed the crime scene, how the incident occurred. So likewise, here the solid evidence is fingerprint, right? Next, please. And also burglary crime scene, all of you know this one, all 457-380 APC. Normally, whenever any crime occur in the night time, 457-380 APC. In the daytime, 434-380 APC of this one. Here, you can see the things are thrown here and there, something like that, right? Here also, what to do is, here we are looking for the fingerprint. Sometime, it may be a real crime scene, or sometime it may be a created crime scene. Because some of the crime scene, what they deserve, the inmate themselves, they create a crime scene like that and they committed a larger complaint there. Nearly 30 lakhs of worth of property loss. Something like that, larger complaint. And sometimes what they do is, the woman, even the woman, working woman, and the maid servant, they are also involved in the crime of this one, right? So here, what to do is, even though we have the automated fingerprint system is there, if it is a first offender, we cannot use this one, automated finger system. So automated finger system, it should be a record collected by the police from the suspect and from the convict or so many things like that, right? So mostly the fingerprints are valuable evidence in the property offenses, mainly house burglaries. Many, many cases I visited in this one, right? Next, please. Right, so this one, already I told you, there are some instances wherein we are getting a fingerprint which is smudged. Smudged in this end, we cannot get a ridges. So we can see only some impression is there, that's all. There is no points or anything like that for comparison. So if it is what the police says, okay, neglected, it is unfit for use. They simply neglected. Since I am an academic here what, by using this impression, what we can do. So what I did was I conducted a small research on this one. So the smudged fingerprint, I find out the length of this, the fingertips, right? Here you can see this one, taking the length of the fingerprint. Then I developed a formula to find out the stature. So estimation of stature from fingerprints, I have studied in Malaysia, this one. So here, we thought that the fingerprint has no use, but still the smudged finger can be used to determine the stature. So stature means we cannot find out exactly what is the height of this person, but approximately the height is between 5.3 to 5.6 or something like that. So this given indication to the police officer, oh, the range is like that. So they will look for the suspect, whoever the height is between the 5 feet to 3 inches to 5 feet to 6 inches. So likewise, this one, I conducted a research on this one. Even though there is no ridges at all, right? Still, we can make use of the fingerprint for the person's identification. I conducted two research on this one. And
Dr. Murthy, sorry to interrupt you.
Yes.
So can you say, focus more light on that? What was that formula and how you have calculated the stature? Because it is really very good to know such things for the budding forensic scientist and fingerprint expert.
Yeah, normally this one, anthropometric methods, normally there are a lot of work done by me in the estimation of stature from footprint. They are all population specific. We cannot take for just like for a particular population. Here you can see this one, the determination of stature from fingerprint Malaysian Malays. Only for that population we have to do this one. We cannot generalize these equations, right? If you got any doubt, you can just put it in the Google, you find out this one, you can see my paper.
Okay.
You can read this one, right? Similarly, I can do this for the Malaysian Chinese population also.
So likewise, the question here is, if you have only one fingerprint has been encountered.
Yeah, so normally one fingerprint is enough. But suppose if you are getting, for example, I am calculating for only index, for example.
Okay.
In the real crime scene, if you are having the ring finger, then we cannot use this formula. So if it is so, what I did was, I used all five fingers.
Okay.
I used all five fingerprints. I derived formula for five formula I developed.
Okay.
So whichever is available in the crime scene, we can make use of this one. So for individual, for one person, I developed 10 formulas. So in the crime scene, suppose if index finger is there, we can make use of that formula.
But that has to go into database completely because
only
then you can identify. Okay, thank you.
Correct. This one, unless or otherwise you are not developing such formula, you cannot do it.
Yeah.
Right. So likewise, the idea is we have to develop the formula, right? So in the crime scene, when you collect the smudged fingerprint or anything like that, then we can make use of this one. That is the idea, Dr. Bhupesh.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much. Yeah, you can go.
Next slide. So this one, all of you know this one. So we have the basic patterns, arch, loop, whorl pattern of this one, right? So here also, by using this one, we can find out the gender, right? Whether it is a male or female or something like that. The reason is, what is the use of this gender mean? In some of the crime scene I visited there, in a property offenser, their maid servants were involved in this crime. Actually, maid servants are working in their home for nearly 9 years, 10 years. The inmates, they're very confident on them. But still, in one instant, the maid servant, he herself, because all the key, everything is known. They know the maid servant know where they are keeping the key. Everything she knows. So she herself just opened the door and collect all the jewels and cash, something like that. And he was working without knowing this one. So when they wanted to open this one, they found the jewels missing. So immediately they called this one. At that time, I had no idea. When I was working as a crime scene investigator, I had no idea about this formula research, nothing. I have zero knowledge. But still that, based on the suspect, they have collected the fingerprint and identified with the maid servant and record the property of this one. So here again, the fingerprint has its own value or something like that. Next, please. Right, this one we have my research I conducted this one. Here what I did was how far the fingerprint pattern inherited from parents to the father, children or something like that. Here what I did was I have collected the fingerprint from, I have chosen 15 Malaysian Indian families, 53 family members. One family means one father, one mother and two children. I collected all their fingerprints, right? They collected the arm, we analyzed what are the patterns or everything like that. Then they investigated the inheritance of the fingerprint pattern mean. Here, it's a very interesting result I found in this one. Mother to son is the highest 82.7%. And father to daughter, 79.6%. Father to son, 71.2%. And the least is mother to daughter, 70.4%. I can say this is something like affection or love or attachment or whatever you may be taking this one, right? Next slide, please. Right, so this is the, I developed the bar graph showing this one, the figure one, frequency of fingerprint pattern among the Malaysian Indian family members. So what are the different type of pattern in the Malaysian family members, all right? So the second one, you can see the frequency of the, for the father, we have the arch pattern, loop pattern, and the double loop word for the father, mother, son, and daughter, just for the make to understand among the family members, I am creating this one, right? And the third one, this is the frequency of finger by gender. Normally, overall male and overall female, it is including the father, son, daughter, something like that, just to get an idea about the loop pattern, what is the frequency, word pattern, what is the frequency, arch pattern, what is the frequency, that is the idea of this one, right? Next slide. Oh, this is our final result. I find out this one. You can see the bar graph is clearly showing that mother has more affection towards son. Of course, she is having the affection towards daughter also. But in the my observation, of course, all of you know this one. In many of our day-to-day life, you know, sometimes some father has affection towards their son and the daughter, something like that. But so far, no study was conducted on this regarding this inheritance of fingerprint and the parents whose children are how far is one. So this is a pilot study. In Malaysia, this is a pilot study. I'm trying this one. So these are the percentage of this one, the mother to son, father to daughter, father to son, and mother to daughter. So now we can, to some extent, we know about the affection of the mother towards son, that is the highest, followed by the father to daughter and father to son, and the last and the least, mother to daughter. Next slide, please. Right, likewise, so that's now I told you, so this is a very interesting finding I observed in this one. I have given the final year project for the students, final year student, I have given a project. So every year I used to give a project for the final year forensic student. So if it is so, I got an idea, we have done in the crimes, you know, so many things, why can't you try this one? Luckily we got a result, because there was no study here. So with the Malaysia, it is a multiracial country, we have the Malay, Chinese, Indians, and so many other ethnic groups are there. So I plan to do it for the extended research for the other ethnic groups also. That's what I planned to do. So you can also do in our countries, even Dubai and some places, you can try how far you can get the result. You can form a database or something like that. So that is the idea of this one, right? Next slide, please. Of course, the next slide. Of course, this is my mother, right? She is my mother. Of course, now she passed away, but still I am carrying her fingerprint pattern. It is with me. It is recorded permanently showing her affection of something like that, right? So likewise, the fingerprint had got not only for the purpose of the identification, we can give some idea about this one. How far the finger pattern transferred to the parents, to the children, and what is their frequency or something. So that is the idea of this one. I got some good, appreciable, satisfied result of this one. Thank you very much for your attention.